Hello everyone, I am Dr. A. Sai Padma, Assistant Professor, Department of Biochemistry, Bhavan Swekananda College, Sainikpuri. In this video, we will be looking at the riboswitch. And the contents I am going to cover are the nature of the riboswitches, function, classification, structure of the riboswitches, occurrence, mechanism of action, and the therapeutic applications of these riboswitches. Coming to the nature of the riboswitches, these are natural RNA sensors which are located either at the 5 prime or the 3 prime untranslated regions of the mRNA, or sometimes they are present even within the introns of the mRNA sequence. And these sensors are capable of binding great variety of small molecules like vitamins, amino acids and the nucleotides. Here we can see one riboswitch to which the small metabolite FMN has been bound, which is present, this riboswitch is present at the 5 prime terminus of the functional mRNA molecule. Coming to the function, the major function of these riboswitches is to regulate the gene expression, mostly at the level of the transcription or the translation of the host mRNA. And this mRNA gets transcribed from the genes which are involved in the biosynthesis, catabolism, or the signaling, or the transport of its binding metabolite. And when the concentration of this metabolite has been increased in the cell, there will be a downregulation. How it is possible? The metabolite goes and binds to the ribose, which in turn will regulate the expression of the gene at the level of the transcription or the translation. And this regulation of the gene by the ribose, which is a fast reaction compared to the other regulatory mechanisms, and which will very quickly adapt to the metabolite concentration within the cell. Coming to the classification of the riboswitches, nearly 40 classes have been identified in different bacteria, fungi, algae, and very few in eukaryotes. And based on the type of the ligands or the metabolites which goes and binds to the riboswitches, they are categorized into majorly four different groups. The first major group of the riboswitch classes belongs to the RNA derived compounds. These are the ligands which goes and binds to the riboswitches. Based on the ligand, the riboswitches are classified or given a class name. For example, thymine pyrophosphate riboswitch, that is one class of the riboswitch. Like that, there are nucleotide derivatives. Based on that, different classes of the riboswitches are present here. In the same way, the signaling molecule, 5 classes of the riboswitches are present in the signaling molecules. That forms a major contribution for the riboswitch classes out of the 40 classes. Coming to the other groups to which the riboswitch classes belongs, in the ions, 5 riboswitch classes, and other metabolites, 5 classes of the riboswitches, and amino acids as the ligands to which 3 classes of the riboswitches. So lysine riboswitch is one class, glycine riboswitches are another class, and so on. Coming to the structural features, here we can see the riboswitch classes of the TPP, guanin, FMN, 2-dimensional and 3-dimensional. These are small in size. They are present either at the 5 prime terminus, R3 prime of the untranslated regions of the mRNA, or sometimes within the introns of the mRNA. Coming to the structural features of the riboswitch, there are two domains. The first domain is called as an aptamer domain, to which the ligand binds, and the ligand binding to the aptamer brings conformational changes in the other domain called as an expression platform. And where they are present, present mostly in the bacteria and also found in the archaea, plants, fungi and algae. So coming to their location within the mRNA, in prokaryotes and fungi, the riboswitches are mostly present at the 5 prime untranslated region. Whereas in the eukaryotes, the riboswitch's function is not in the regulation of the transcription or the translation. Instead, they are involved in the alternate splicing mechanism, which leads to production of the different types of the final mRNA transcript out of the pre-mRNA transcript. So, the number of the mRNAs which will be resulted out of one single pre-mRNA will be more in number, which leads to different types of the proteins which will get synthesized from the different mRNAs. Basically, the pre-mRNA transcript is same, single, but out of that, because of the alternate splicing, many different types of the mature mRNAs will be produced and the different polypeptides will be synthesized. Coming to the higher plants, this alternate splicing produces not different types of mRNA, instead which produces a long 3' untranslated mRNA, which will make the mRNA unstable and leads to the degradation. That itself is in a regulation of the gene by making the mRNA highly unstable. Coming to the mechanism of action, here we'll be discussing two major mechanisms which the riboswitches operate. One is at the level of the transcription. Here we can see the riboswitch with the aptamer to which the ligand is not bound. So the aptamer along with the expression platform are favorable for the transcription process. The RNA polymerase is bound to the gene, that is the DNA, and transcribing the gene produces the full length mRNA. The mRNA gets translated to a full length polypeptide, a functional protein or the enzyme, which is necessary for a particular metabolite to get synthesized or to get transported into the cell. But if the metabolite concentration has been increased to the required levels within the cell, then it should be down regulated at the level of the transcription or translation. In this case, the ligand goes and binds to the aptamer, leads to the conformational chain, will pass on to the expression platform. Now the expression platform has been adapted into the terminator conformation and RNA polymerase is no more able to bind to the DNA and RNA hybrid helix. It gets detached from the DNA RNA hybrid helix and this mRNA is of no use because it is abruptly untranscribed from the DNA and polypeptide cannot be synthesized. So there is no way where some more metabolite can be synthesized because there is no availability of the enzymes at that particular point of time. That is the case of the transcriptional regulation. Coming to the translation, here the mRNA is already been fully transcribed, but how the ligand is controlling the translation with the help of the riboswitch. Here the ligand is not present in excess concentration, so it has to be synthesized. The aptamer is an open conformation and the ribosome goes and binds at the ribosome binding site, which is present at the expression platform of the riboswitch. So the ribosome continues to the place of the start codon and the polypeptide will be synthesized in full length. A functional enzyme will be translated and which will help in synthesis of the ligand to the required optimal levels. But if the ligand has been synthesized or been transported into the cell and it has to be down regulated in its synthesis, then it happens at the level of the stopping of the translation. How it is happening? The ligand goes and binds to the aptamer, leads to the conformational chain, in turn leads to the conformational change of the expression platform where the ribosome binding site has been sequestered. It is not available for the ribosome to come and then bind on the mRNA. So without ribosome binding, the translation process cannot happen and the enzyme cannot be synthesized. So these are the two major ways by which the riboswitches will help either the transcription to be continued or transcription to be terminated, or at the level of the translation, either translation to be continued in absence of the ligand, but the ligand binding leads to the translational inhibition. Coming to the last point, as the ribose switches as the antibiotic targets, and these ribose switches can be targeted for the expression of the genes which are necessary for the bacterium for its survival. How it is happening? The antibiotic will be having in a structural analogy with one of the ligand of the ribose switch classes. For example, here if we take thymine pyrophosphate class of the ribose switches, pyrethymine, it is an antibiotic which has a structural analog, structural resemblance to the thymine. Once this pyrethymine has been administered as the antibiotic, it goes to the bacterial cell, gets converted into pyrethymine pyrophosphate, like just normal thymine pyrophosphate, and this pyrethymine pyrophosphate goes and binds to the thymine pyrophosphate ribose switch. Because of the structural resemblance, it takes up as the ligand, and this switches of the synthesis of the enzymes which are necessary for further synthesis of the thymine pyrophosphate or the import proteins which are present in the membrane of the bacteria. Once the synthesis of these enzymes or the proteins has been stopped, so the bacteria cannot survive because there is no enough levels of the thymine pyrophosphate synthesized. The other potential advantage that ribose switches has as an antibiotic target is that many of the ribose switches have multiple copies per the genome, and each copy controls an operon containing many genes, and these genes are very much essential for the survival of the bacteria. So therefore, in order for the bacteria to evolve resistance to the antibiotics which are being administered by the mutations, it is not possible to have mutations for all these multiple copies for the genome. Even a single ribose switch which is functional can stop further synthesis of the enzymes which are necessary to synthesize the particular ligand. And